Hello guys, welcome to Survival Russia. Today we're gonna make some food. We're gonna cook from my backup pouch, my survival pouch, food pouch. The most important part of my backup kit actually. And it should be the most important part of any or most backup kits. Food pouch, very important. Yeah, we're gonna make a Siberian, small Siberian log fire here from the wood I cut for in the Gumboy 2000 video. And I cleaned out a little space here with my feet, but let's get on with this cooking stuff here, because I'm hungry. Lots of birch bark here, comes off a dead standing birch over there actually. But I'm not sure whether the wood is dry enough. I just use a large amount of birch bark, that sort of like should get things going. So guys, what I want to do today is to show how to make a really awesome and energizing, revitalizing meal from the food pouch here, the backup food pouch. Some of you know it, but this is the food pouch I would dump in my small foldable backpack, or what you can say, get away from camp or when I leave camp kind of a thing, you know. So we always have some stuff with us in case we should not be able to find our way back. So yeah, it's not very full right now, and what I'm gonna use for this meal here is my buckwheat, of course, and the salted meat that I had made a few videos on how to make. Because the salted meat here, as I said, it can be eaten raw, but Sergey, he does it all the time. But some food agencies, they claim that the salting and the smoking and meats and so on, it does not consistently get rid of the spiral worm, I forget what it's called, but you know what I mean. So yeah, I cannot say you should eat it raw, but I eat it raw. It's not raw, I mean, it's been in a salt, heavy salt brine with onion and garlic for 4 days, right? But anyway, what it also can be used for is to cut into slices and to boil it together with the buckwheat. The buckwheat is awesome. This is a roasted buckwheat. This is quite old actually, this is why I'm gonna use it now. Because I'm gonna set up my food pouch here again for this winter here, and normally I will also carry a can of canned pork, pig meat as I call it, but today we're having this because it's winter. It's not very cold today, 0 degrees. We had some heat coming in from the south, not too awesome, but anyway, it will not go bad anytime soon because it's salted, as I said. So let's get on with that. One advantage with the buckwheat is that it contains a lot of amino acids. That means that you will be able to digest and absorb and make use of, so to speak, 90% of the protein in the buckwheat, because protein has about 17-20% protein. The amino acids make sure that your body will absorb it. That also goes for the meat, of course, and the meat, as you can see or will see in a moment, of course also contains a good amount of fat. So we have all sorts of good things going on for us here. I will cook it over the Siberian log fire there with the traditional Siberian cooking stand I also made a video on, and I will use my mess kit, which is also a steady item in the emergency pouch. One thing I pointed out in an earlier video is that in this mess kit here I have a very important item, because I carry cups and tea and stuff like that, spoons and lighters and stuff in the mess kit. So an important item to have is a bag that we can empty the contents of our mess kit into. Boom. This is a real survival meal. This is what we will need in a survival or emergency situation. I also have my stainless steel bottle with me, which is also a part of the kit I would bring as a real survival kit, not the small Altoids tins. But what was it I was doing here? Yeah, I was looking for a cup, because we're gonna need a cup, and in the cup I have tea and sugar. I don't know why, but I don't like to drink coffee in the forest. I never ever drink coffee in the forest, I don't know why. Anyway, we have our buckwheat here, and we're gonna see how much we have. But anyway, this much here is certainly enough for a meal or two, especially in an emergency. So, what do we have here? It's like half a cup. I can try and show you, but doesn't really go on the cam. It's a little less than half a cup, I'd say a third of a cup. A third of a cup, that means that we need double the amount of water and maybe a little bit more. So, and since we have some meat with us and so on, we'll just add a full cup and maybe a little bit of a dab. We don't need any salt in this because the salt we already have in the meat here. So let's get it on the fireplace there. Because I'm hungry, I've been out here all day. See if I can find a way up here for the Loise, for the Survival Russia vehicle. I made a little notch up here, of course. This cooking stand here is a little bit on the taller side. Let's see if we can get it to work anyway. This should be fine. But if I was in a real emergency, I would not have that flat of an angle on the cooking stand, that's for sure. It might flip over. I think that we are gonna, to begin with, just put the mess kit on the top here. It's gonna make it a little bit faster. So here we have the meat. If you're not familiar with this, then I can say this meat here have been salted in very salty brine for 4 days. Also, the brine have been packed with the meat here and with a lot of onion and with a lot of garlic. So this is rather salt and kind of spicy. So for an emergency cooking situation, I would say one of these chunks here would be more than enough, but I have good amount of it at home, so I will cut this in some thin slices so it will boil as fast as possible, or will be boiled all the way through as fast as possible anyway. I'll also try not to cut into my my ground pad here. And the meat here is of course completely void of, not completely, but there are not much juices or anything, water especially, in this meat any longer. That means that it will not freeze, even straight out of the freezer, it you can still cut it with a knife. It's of course a little bit hard, but it will not be like a fresh raw meat. I mean, this meat here have been packed with a heavy weight on top while it was in the brine. So yeah, you can go and watch the video, something like how to salt meat like our grandmothers did it, or something along those lines. Maybe I'll put a link in the description, you can check them out, the description. There are all sorts of useful stuff. If you want to support the channel, there's definitely links to that. And thank you to all of you guys who do that. But here we have a fair amount of meat, and we could carry as much as we want in the forest of this stuff here. Ooh, we have a rather good heat up here. I'll take this off here real fast. So we'll take our emergency meat here and just dunk all of it in together with the buckwheat here. We'll put it up here like before. Alright guys, let's take a look here. I will use the big camera, because the big camera actually has a flashlight, and I've never really used it, so let's try it out. A steaming hot meal. See what it looks like down here. It looks like buckwheat with meat actually. It might not look too awesome, but smells really, really awesome. It's a relatively powerful flashlight this little guy has. But yeah, this is of course also relatively warm. Here's some of the meat. It looks pretty well done. Let's taste the buckwheat. Yeah, so I had to get you guys out of the smoke, out of the campfire smoke. But this tastes awesome. I can really taste the onion and garlic that the meat have been sort of like curing in. I'll try some of the meat here. It's of course rather warm. That's really nice. This is what you need, or I need, if I was trapped in a forest or something like that. That is for sure. And the buckwheat, I talked a lot of buckwheat about buckwheat, and this is gonna get winter now, and I'm gonna talk about buckwheat again. I know some of you guys are most likely a little bit tired of listening to me talking about buckwheat, but it's kind of a superfood actually. What do we have here? We have maybe a little bit more than a... What do we have? Yeah, something like this. A third, or between a third and a quarter of a mezcal full. Guys, there's not much more to say than I hope you liked the video and you found it informational, and I hope you will try out and make the salted pork for yourselves, because it's a great food for the winter. And it's easy to cook with and all that good stuff. And why eat MREs and dry foods and so on if we don't really need to, right? So guys, check the links in the description and share, subscribe, sub bell, sub like and all that good stuff. And until next time, get out and train, get it done, do something awesome. See you in the next video, guys. Thank you for your time. Thank you for your support.